What do you look for when selecting a cookbook to use with your food storage? I personally look for 5 things. Number 1, I don't want to see exotic ingredients in the recipes, like a spice I'll only use in that one recipe. I want to see common ingredients based on staples that I'm likely to have on hand. Secondly, I don't want complicated, fussy procedure. For example, I may be cooking with my Sun Oven, and a recipe that calls for baking at 350 degrees for 20 minutes, followed by baking at 450 degrees for 10 minutes, would be problematic. Another important factor I look for is flexibility. Can you easily substitute ingredients? Can I use dried, fresh, or canned fruit? How about whole wheat flour instead of white? Does the recipe instruct how to make these changes? I don't know what I may have on hand at the time. Lastly, do the recipes in the book offer economy and good nutrition? These are the criteria I use in selecting the cookbooks I am recommending. Now, there are thousands of cookbooks out there to choose from. But in the case of the homesteading prepper, not too many of these cookbooks have recipes for the common extended pantry or food storage basics, such as dried beans, whole grains, honey, dry milk, dehydrated egg powder, dried fruit, and vegetables. So the field is narrowed considerably when it comes to planning meals and dishes around those items. Enter the Mormon community to the rescue. As part of the Mormon church doctrine, members are expected to have a 1-year supply of food on hand for every member of the family. This has been done for generations. They have become experts at not only preserving food for extended periods, but also on how to organize a food storage program and how to use it. The Mormon Church has also done extensive research on the shelf life of staples. So it's not surprising that, in my opinion, the best cookbooks out there for using your food storage for the homestead prepper comes from authors who are members of or affiliated with the Mormon Church. The first cookbook is Cooking with Food Storage Made Easy by Debbie Harmon, published in 2009. It retails for just over $16 at Amazon.com. This book is very visually appealing, with large print and a spiral binding that lays flat nicely. This book is noteworthy because it gives amounts one should store of not only staples, but also flavorings, condiments, seasonings, and spices. A very important but often overlooked aspect of successful food storage. Plus, how much to store of other foods are covered, such as dehydrated fruits and vegetables and canned meats. The amounts suggested in the book are for a family of 6 for 1 year, so you will have to estimate adjustments for your family size, but it's a good starting point. The book also has helpful tips throughout. There are short sections on gardening, canning, dehydrating, and sprouting as well. There are some innovative recipes in this book, such as wheat spaghetti on page 67, which substitutes wheat berries for ground beef. There are also a lot of bean recipes. It's important to note, however, that the bread recipes do call for added gluten, which may be a problem for some people. Lastly, there's an emergency section giving the ingredients for a basic 72-hour kit with pointers in the back. Next book from another LDS church member is I Can't Believe It's Food Storage by Crystal Godfrey, published in 2009 and available at Amazon.com for a little over $12. The author approaches the subject matter with the idea the reader is skeptical or reluctant to try cooking with food storage. The book leads the reader into food storage in stages, starting with a 3-month supply and building to a year. Each component of a basic food storage system is discussed as far as nutritional value, proper storage, and where to buy. Just so you know, there are many biblical references as well as quotes from LDS church leaders in support of food storage. I don't think this takes away from the book at all, but some might. The author also has an extensive website, everydayfoodstorage.net. If you like what you find there, you will likely like this book as well. Finally, in our LDS lineup of cookbooks, there is, in my humble opinion, the mothership of all food storage reference cookbooks. It's called The New Cooking with Home Storage by Vicki, Tate, published in 1993. It's an expanded and better version of the 1991 original publication. It retails for $15 and is available from usaemergencysupply.com. It is spiral bound and spans over 300 pages. It's not a large book, though. Comprehensive, it utilizes a lot of very old pioneer recipes, including a section on home remedies. There is a superabundance of helpful tips throughout, and blank pages at the beginning of each section to record your own notes, modifications, or additional recipes. Recipes also often give substitution options. There are sections on using a Dutch oven, rehydrating dried vegetables, sprouting, and a survival prepper section at the back. Unique recipes for brand name products are also included, such as wheat thins, corn chips, and grape nut cereal. There is even a simple recipe for homemade emergency survival bars, as well as an eggless, milkless, and butterless cake. You will also find how-tos such as making homemade yeast and cooking wheat in a thermos for breakfast cereal. The very first recipe offered in is the infamous Amish Friendship Bread, from scratch, of course. If you can afford no other food storage cookbook, this is the one you should buy.